Ladies and gentlemen, a semi-legend in her own lifetime, Miss Joan Rivers.
Perfect! What a nice audience. Thank you for coming. That's just just lovely. It is so nice to be here. And everything I'm wearing, you like what I'm wearing? Because it's all been lent to me. Lent to me. Those scum of the airlines have lost all my clothes, all my luggage. Everything I'm wearing has been lent to me or found. This sweater, which I love, I found in the closet right next to Liberace. Isn't that lucky? It's just... Oh, grow up. Just grow up. Liberace is gay. He's carrying Truman Capote's baby. Everybody... Oh, sure. Everybody knows that. He would have been here tonight, but he had a yeast infection. His big fantasy is to have Tom Selleck as a proctologist. And you know who I know who's gay and who's not gay? Can we talk here? Let me tell you how I know who is gay and who is not gay. I read the National Enquirer. Don't you read the Enquirer? Who said no? Are you kidding? What do you read when you go to the bathroom? I cannot go. I open up the Enquirer, I automatically go, this is fabulous. It's replacing bran muffins. It is. Oh, shh. Let me tell you why I love the Enquirer, okay? Let me tell you why I love it. I love the Enquirer because it is filled with stupid stories. If you want to read something intelligent, then don't buy the Enquirer. We don't need you. Then you buy the New York Review of Literature, you buy the Partisan Review, you buy the Harper's, you buy Atlantic, the National Enquirer, UFO sightings. That's the caliber, right? UFO sightings, and never by anybody intelligent. Have you ever noticed that? A UFO has never landed at Harvard or Yale or Princeton. It's always two assholes with Coors beer in a recreational vehicle. I was skinning rabbits in the woods. It screwed Minnie. I enjoyed it. And a sauce has never landed on a Jewish lawn because we would turn it over to see who made it. I read every issue. Do you read it? Oh, how can you not read it? Then you miss about me and Sinatra. I was in the National Enquirer. I am suing Frank Sinatra for support for the 4 years I would have lived with him if he had asked me. Oh, yes. See, that they look at me. That's a very Beverly Hills joke. Because out here at Beverly Hills, everyone's... The only worry about is palimony and drugs. Oh, druggy. Look how quiet the room got. Oh, because everything is druggy. Am I right? You into drugs? Yeah, I figured. Yeah, you look it. That's a... You're laughing 4 jokes back. That's what tipped me off. Can we talk here? I'm not into drugs. Every once in a while, when I'm feeling a little depressed, I take some Fresca and throw it on a panty shield. It picks you right up. You could just disco all night. Let's go. Because in California's druggy. Oh, come on. Oh, look how quiet the room goes. Oh, please. California, if it is white and it's on the table, they are going to sniff it. Oh, yes. I have a friend who OD'd in the beauty shop on dandruff. I can tell you. Oh, certainly. That's why I knew about DeLorean, right? Who is innocent. Oh, come on. I knew about the DeLorean car. It came with snow tires. It was so obvious. Is a spoon. Everybody, you hit the horn instead of it going beep, beep, it went toot, toot. See, California, because California, you're from California?
New York.
That's where we can talk, New York, yeah. How long are you living out here? 5 years. I'm living here, God, 9 years. I miss New York. You know why I like New York? It was tough. The city was tough. The Statue of Liberty carried a gun. I was so impressed. Oh, yes! I lived in an apartment building in the basement. We had a washer dryer with a rape cycle. Oh, absolutely. Oh, yes! It was a tough city. You'd walk out, you see a cop frisking a horse. And the women are tough. See, here in California, the women are too late. They're too, like, the women in California are, like, too, they get scared, you know? A guy flashes you, they go to pieces. He's flashing. New York, a guy flashes you, you took your embroidery hoop, you played ring toss. Oh, shh. Get him 2 out of 3. Oh, I know. See, you know what city I hate? Well, with Billings, Montana. Did you ever go there? Are you going there? Don't go. Better to die in a plane crash. If you have a choice, landing in Billings and going down in a plane, go down that goddamn plane. Women in high heels and socks. Have you ever been there? The 7-Eleven store is called 2-5. It's so stupid. They had a fashion show at Sears Roebuck. No models. They held open the catalog and they would point, and the women would go like, on the stage, and you want to be good, even though it's Billings, Montana, you want to be hot. You know, I come on the stage, and I look down where you're sitting. There was a woman nursing a child. I thought, look at this group. Well, so what? You find that normal? You find that normal to have a woman walk into a nightclub and nurse a child? Who would you watch? Me or the nursing mother? Who would you watch? Kid was 14 years old. Who would you watch? Turned out it wasn't hers, thank God. Oh. See, I'm telling you that, Joe. You don't have a kid, do you? You're single. Yeah, no, you're single though, right? Yeah, because you sit very cute. You can tell, yeah. Yeah, you're single, yeah. No, you're married. Yeah, look at the posture. You can tell from posture. Yeah. No, look, single girls always sit better than married women. Single girls sit perky, boobies up, smile, song, oh. They talk a lot with their tongue. Hi, how are you? The whole body goes like, thank God. The boobies hit the knees, the legs spread, a shopping bag goes plunk. That's a married woman. And you find yourself at McDonald's on Mother's Day with a corsage going, this is the answer. Oh, don't you hate McDonald's? I read you cannot get a job working there unless you have a skin condition. It is, oh. What do you have, lady? Pucky, pucky, pucky. A wash and dry. And, oh, they all look like Rod Stewart. Aren't rock stars? Can we talk here? Aren't rock stars ugly? I was on the Carson show 2 times ago, and I mentioned rock stars were ugly, and I got letters from all over America. Rock stars are not ugly. Rod Stewart. Rod Stewart. He has got acne. I think you could play Connect the Dots for a year on this man's face. Do you think I'm sexy? Squish, 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 squish. Manilow knows if he was on hard drugs, he could inhale Peru. The one with the lips, the one with the lips, the big lips, the lips, the lips. Mick Jagger! He could French kiss a moose. I have never seen that. He could suck a lemon from here to the Beverly Wilshire Hotel. Oh, shh. He's got childbearing lips. And, oh, shh. Stevie Wonder, that poor son of a bitch. Who's gonna tell him he's wearing a macrame plant holder on his head? And yet, it doesn't matter, damn it, because a man, as long as he's alive, he can be rich, he can be poor, he can be clean, he can be dirty, he is a catch. That's why you're single. Remember, you have a limited amount of time. You're a woman. A man, this son of a bitch you're with, is not gonna marry you. This son of a bitch, he's gonna be around till he's 98. We have an extra man, bring him along. He's 98, bring him. He's dead, we'll prop him, bring him. Oh, sure. Of course, they're double standards even today. Oh, look at the room, suddenly so quiet. Oh, come on, there are still double standards. A man can sleep around and sleep around, nobody asks any question. A woman, you make 19, 20 mistakes, right away you're a tramp. Oh, shit! To be a woman. How old are you? 30. You're very cute. Yes, did you go to college? Yes. That's why you're too smart. Men like them stupid. Oh, no, no. Oh, man. Oh, what? Oh, grow up. Don't give me all this liberation shit. Men like them stupid. Oh, all you need is a pretty face and a trick pelvis and you're home free. And oh, shit. The generation where they never told you these things. I'm the generation where you had your. I was 28 years old and single. Oh, my mother was going crazy. How old were you when you got married? 23, so no chicken either. Yeah, yeah. Did you wear white? Okay, excuse me. I don't want to hear. So defensive, yes. Were you a nurse? Also, I had a big black hem on my dress. Oh, I walked down the aisle, every usher went, white. When the rabbi said, you take this man, 14 guys said she has. Oh, it's just, my husband bought the horseback riding story, thank God. But so did Prince Charles. Poor bitch to marry her off to a gay guy. And so that. Grow up! Don't you read the Inquirer? Prince Charles is gay. He can't wait for the mother to die. He can become queen. Oh, shit! Do you think he's good looking, Prince Charles, those stupid ass ears on him? He go, he'll hang glide over the Falkland Islands. Oh. Those ears, he could pick up cable TV. And he could play ping pong without a paddle. Oh, shoot. Do you find them good looking in the royal family? Because my husband's English, he thinks they're good looking. Can we talk here? A bunch of dogs. A bunch of dogs. Go out in the street, call their names. Queenie, Duke, and Prince.